Okay, so a fellow by the name of Francesco got in touch with me about making this adapter plate for the Makita trim router. And in a previous video, I made one to fit on here on my router table. It was a bit of a mess. And I said, yeah, why not? I had an idea. What I wanted to do is see if I could cut one out on the CNC machine, but also when cutting out, also produce the template that you would use to produce the recess on whatever surface you wanted to use as a router table. It sounded like a good idea to do, and then I completely forgot about it. And then 2 months later, Francesco got back in touch with me and asked me, well, have you done anything about this idea you had? And I said, I completely forgot.
So I'm going to have a crack at this now, and I'm starting by scanning the fixed base mount of my router, which I will create the template from. I have a good feeling about this, and although I'll have to countersink the holes for the screw heads and tap the other holes for the leveling screws by hand, the difficult stuff of spacing everything accurately should be done on the CNC machine. This is providing I've worked out the diagram correctly and haven't made any mistakes. Then Francesco will be able to use the offcut from the CNC machine as a template to cut the recess which the plates will sit into. So after the base was scanned, I opened the file in Illustrator and created some vectors over the screw holes and router bit opening. I then exported this as a DXF file, worked on it in ArtsCAM to merge the vectors and define the final layout, and finally exported it as an SVG file, which I could open in Easel and send to the CNC machine to cut. For some reason, I couldn't open the SVG file from Illustrator directly in Easel.
Okay, I'm going to start by cutting the holes for the actual mount, which are these ones here. They're about 4 mil, so I'm using a 1/8 of an inch up spiral bit to do that, and then I'm going to cross over to the 1/4 inch bit to do the rest. Well, it was almost perfect until that happened. What can you do? The main thing is the actual template is fine and the inside cut came out okay.
I unscrewed the plate from the CNC machine, countersunk the holes on the pillar drill, and checked if the plate would screw onto the underside of the router mount.
Holes look pretty good. A little bit tight. So the holes are perfectly aligned. I think I've made them a little bit smaller than I should have. I've probably done them exactly the same size as the screws, which are, I think, 4 M4 screws, machine screws. But that is on. That's amazing. So you can make your own table router plate on a CNC machine and produce the template that you could then cut that shape out onto a tabletop or board. I slightly did my measurements wider than the actual one that I had. I'm not sure how I did that. So they are slightly different, but where it counts, the actual holes are correct. So that's pretty good. Anyway, this means I'm not going to send my old one to Francesco and keep the new one. So I'm going to just test the template out before I send it. And this is the bushing on the Makita plunge base. It's a little bit deep, by about 2 mil. So what I'm going to do is just use these washers. There's two washers here, probably about 1.5 mil. So combined, there'll be 3 mil. Just to give me that added height.
I checked the bit was centered in the bushing using this hardwood homemade centering cone. I then routed only 3 faces of the template.
Okay, so we're just looking at this line here as the test. I did a couple, and when I butt one corner up against it, it looks pretty good. But then when I go to the opposite end, if I can show you, so you can see that follows the cut path pretty well. But on the opposite end, it is literally a couple mil off on one side.
So I went back to ArtsCam to try and identify what I had done wrong. I kind of thought maybe it's the bushing, it's not centered. Maybe the plunge base has a little bit of wobble. Maybe I'd done some maths wrong. It wouldn't be the first time. But in the end, it turned out I had done some maths wrong. Or more to the point, I had done some maths correctly, but later ignored it while cutting. So the two circles that I'm moving on screen represent a 16 mm bushing, which comes with the router, and a 1/4 inch or 6.35 mm bit. I had worked out the outside template size based on the fact that I only had a 16 mm bushing for that Makita router. That's what it comes with. But when I went to cut the pieces out, I used a 1/4 inch bit to cut the plate and the template at the same time, which meant the template was 6.35 mm larger on all sides. So there's only 3 things I can do now, and those are either route a new template, use a larger bushing, or use a smaller router bit. So I worked out what size bushing I needed from the diagram for the incorrect template, and that would have been 19 mm, but when I checked whether Makita provide that size, they don't. They only do 20 mm and 30 mm. I couldn't find any other measurements. And the router bit would have to be a little over 3 mm to compensate for the error I had made. So it looks like I'm going to have to make a new template. So I routed along the template on some scrap and then cut an opening so I could check the fit. The rebate is only 6.35 mm wide, but for the actual opening, the lip should be between 3 and 4 cm, so the height adjusting grub screws can rest on something. The fit is really tight, and I think I need to modify the digital file so it's 0.5 mm larger. I bought another piece of Perspex, this time 8 mm thick, and prepared the new template, which I have imported into Easel. There are a few extra holes next to the leveling grub screws. I realised that instead of trying to make a perfect fit, the plate could be leveled and screwed onto the rebate of the opening, preventing any vibration from the router loosening the grub screws. Before cutting, I noticed one of the polycarbonate wheels on the CNC machine had broken.
I probably put it on too tight, so I'm going to need to replace it with this Delrin one.
I cut another test template out on the CNC machine and routed yet another channel to check the spacing of the original router plate.
Okay, that looks pretty good. I think I just need to widen this up. The machine is still not as accurate as I like, but this is why I want to cut the template and the router plate at the same time, because providing that they're orientated the same way, you should be able to fit it regardless of the imperfections caused by a belt driven CNC machine. Mm-hmm. did have a little bit of a boo-boo here, but I should be able to countersink that out. Okay, that's pretty good. And then obviously you put the grub screws in these outer holes, and then these inner ones you can line it up and screw it down. So I haven't done the recess as deep as I should have for an actual insert. I just done it a little bit just to show that it fits. And that's all the way around. The recess around needs to be much wider so the screws actually sink into the material a little bit better. But that's not bad. Also, when I cut this opening out with a jigsaw, you can do that with the router by putting some strips inside the template. Anyway, I'm gonna wrap this up and send it to Mr. Francesco, and I hope he has a lot of fun making things. I'll also put a link to his Instagram page in the description, so hopefully you can see some images of his lovely garden and also him installing this.
If you'd like to see how I did the original router insert plate without the CNC machine or the centering cone, those videos will be in the information card. You can also see more CNC related videos by checking my second channel, Educate and Savas, or find me on Instagram for sneaky previews of future projects. As always, please sacrifice a thumb so I can keep the algorithm gods happy, and I'll see you in the future.